Okay, let's show a graph traversal using depth first expansion. So as an example, let me draw a graph here again. Okay, so there's just a graph showing the connectivity, what edges are connected to what. So with a depth first traversal, what we do is we are going to maintain a stack of the children that we will be that will be adjacent to an edge that we to a node that we visit. So let's just start for the example's sake, we'll start at 1, and these are undirected edges. So here's our stack right here, and our top of the stack is going to be right here. Okay, so we'll be pushing in from this side and popping off of that side as well. So when I hit the 1, when I do the 1 has these edges right here. So I will put those elements onto the stack. So I have, let's see, let's do it 7, 3, 2. So 7, 3, 2. Push 7, push 3, push 2. Okay, so at the next cycle, so here's my 1. So at the next cycle of the algorithm, I will pop the 2 off the stack. So there will be my 2. So my stack is now 7, 3. And then I will push 2's children onto the stack, which will be 3 and 4. I don't push the 1 because 1 has already been on the stack. So I'll push the 3 and the 4. Not the 3, sorry. 3 is already on the stack. So I push the 4 onto the stack. There's my new stack element right there. Okay, so then I pop the 4 off the stack. So that gives me, that's the child of 2. So I pop the 4 off the stack. My current stack is 7, 3. I push 4's children on the stack. 3 is already present, been visited. 4 is the new thing that I'm adding to the stack. So there's my 5 right there. So I add my 5 to the stack, fresh. Okay, I now pop the 5 off. And the 5 is the child of 4 right there. So my current stack is 7, 3. So at this point, let's see, I visited 1. 2, 4, and 5. So 5's children gets pushed to the stack. 4 has already been hit. 3 is already on the stack. No other children. So I pop the 3 off the stack. Let's see. So 3 is on the stack. So that means I have 7 now on the stack. 3 is on the stack because it was a child of 1. So there's my 3 right there. Okay, when I take 3 off the stack, I push 3's children. That's only 6. That's the only thing that's new. Okay, so I pop the 6 off the stack. So that gives me 3's child 6 right there. And I push only the child of, the only child left of 6 is 7, but 7 is already on the stack right there. So I pop the 7 off. And of course, 7 is the child of 1. So I now have an empty stack and I'm done. Okay, let's do this again, but this time I'm going to start at a different start node. Let's just do it right here, huh? So we'll just draw the same nice clean picture of my graph. 3, 5, like so. Okay, so here's my node, and here's the stack. This time, let's start at, how about if we start at 2 this time? Okay, so I start at 2. 2 has children 1, 3, and 4. And let me push them on in that order. 1, 3, and 4. Remember, this is the top of the stack right here. So 2 right there is where I'm starting to build my tree. Okay, so I pop the 4 off the stack. So there's 2 and 4. 4 was a child of 2, so add that onto that thing. And I add, now 3 is already on the stack, but 4 gets added. 5. 5 is newly added, so 1, 3, push the 5. Okay, so I pop the 5 off the stack. 5 is a child of 4, that's why I got it. So that takes care of the five is pushed off, and five's children are only three and four. Three and four have already been hit, so I don't add anything to the stack. I pop the three off. Now, three got put on the stack because it was a child of two, so the three is a child of five, but the reason it was on the stack is here when it was a child of two. It was related to two, so that's why I've got this two as a parent of three right here. Okay, so when I pop the three off, I have to add three's children. I've got six is the only new child to add right there. So that's a visit right there. Okay, so I add, pop the six off, and six is a child of three, so that gets added right there. Okay, six new child is seven. So I add the seven right there. Okay, pop the seven off. Seven is a child of six, so there's seven. Okay, leaving only one on the stack. Seven has no other related adjacent nodes that haven't already been on the stack. So when I pop seven off, I'm left with one on the stack. Pop the one off the stack, and the one was on the stack because it was a child of two right here. See that? So one is a child of two, and I now have an empty stack, and I'm done. So you can see, if I were to go back to this this graph, well, let me redraw the graph here. Okay, so for this traversal right here, I found this tree right here. We started, I'll put a head note like that, okay? I started two, and then that's that first, going down that first branch, and then three, six, seven, going down this branch right here, and then one going down that branch. So that's the tree that I construct from starting at two and doing depth first traversal right there. This one right here, I do a really different picture so that we can, I'm gonna put this tree on top of here. I start at one and I have two, three, and seven. That's the first, the zeroth level and the first level. Two adds level four, and then four adds level on five, and then the three will add the six, and we're done. So, and then the head of that tree is right there.